ready. I'm not even to my full capacity.
Where you see him?
See Ernie Davidson in the neighborhood.
This is his favorite problems. Chinese restaurant right over here.
We see him. We don't see anybody else. You know.
Definitely. Man. Leave Ernie Davis alone, campaign.
You know what? Why did they reelect him?
I'm absolutely you know what? In Ernie's
favor. They tried to vote him out. They did. And you know what? They reelected him. They found nothing on him.
All they worried about is slandering, being conniving, and backstabbing. They don't come to my burning about nothing. They don't even come to my burning to see about what's for the better good, what's going on in my burning. They don't care not one bit. As you can see, all they do is just sit around and wait. All they do is worry about is harassing the mayor, harassing the community about nothing but a bunch of propaganda and lies. Now, they standing here. Now, my question is, we got a movie shoot going on, my brother. Now, isn't that a good enough event? So why are they not down there? You understand what I'm saying? They worry about too much of the political part of things. They need to worry about what's the most positive thing outside of political. Like they said, they feel rats. That's exactly what they are. And that's exactly who they act as feel rats.
You know what?
I thought in America you're innocent until found guilty.
Yes.
Someone said, a trial by the press is no trial at all. It's a lynching. So. With that, need said no more. They asked me when I was coming in, is this for the mayor's re-election campaign? I said, you're a little premature.
This is for dinner.
It says, what is this for? And I say, so that we can introduce everybody to an innocent man.
Mmm.
Mount Vernon, be torn apart for those who would like to achieve higher office. You don't win leadership by stealing it. You win it at the ballot box. Thank you all.
Go. All right.
Because the promise of America is freedom, and
We choose that freedom to live where we want to live. Many of us have chosen to live in Mount Vernon. We choose that freedom to drive what we can afford. We use that freedom to go into business for ourselves and become a success. And so we live with that promise of freedom. And we also choose the freedom to associate with the elected officials that we want to associate with. And so all of you are here tonight because you have chosen to support Ernie Davis.
Yeah!
And you have the freedom to do so. And nobody, regardless of their accusations, will take that freedom away from us. The reporter asked me a question. I said, I have no idea what you're talking about. They said, you don't read the paper? I said, I'm a businessman. I read the business section. I read the important part of the news. Because that's what matters to people's lives. And when someone sacrifices so many years as a county legislator, as an assessor, as a building commissioner, and then becomes mayor of a city, and sacrifices all of that time to make a city better, we should applaud that. We should,
hey.
We should encourage that. And for so many reasons, young people are choosing not to go into public office and to public service. Because one mistake in your life and boom, they'll slash you right down. So let us continue to rally around a good man who's done a good job, who supports business in this city.
Thank my Irish daughter, Caitlin. Where is Caitlin?
Caitlin!
And let me thank all of the committee and especially all of the friends who've gathered here. I shan't be long, but I would like to just tell you how gratified I am that you came. There are some people who shy away from controversy. There are some people who feel that somehow they have to walk the straight and narrow when it comes to the truth. We gather here because we believe in a great city. We believe that yep. The city can be the best it can be only if we care, only if we stand up when we see wrongness, because the children are watching. When we look at our city and we look at the transgressions of the present and the past, we know that all of us own what is happening. If we develop systems that don't work, if we develop, whether it's a justice system or school system or whatever, we know that we have something to do with it, either by omission or commission. Someone would ask, why at this time in my life would I choose to come into a system that tried to kill me in the first instance? Well, one thing is very noteworthy to me. I think about my parents and I think about the struggles that they've gone through. I think about my granddaddy who owned a farm when black people didn't own anything. He built his own. And he is one of my heroes, my mother and my father, and all of the people I've run across that stood up. There is no leadership that's comfortable. And once you understand that if you're going to take the mantle of leadership, you're going to suffer the pains and errors of those who are uninitiated, or those who would dare to destroy you for their own benefit. And so I stand here understanding that. But even as I stand here, I have friends who come to my aid. I have ministers who come and give me certain passages, Psalm 37 and 92 is specific. And trust me, it does give you some solace because it reacquaints you with history. It reacquaints you with that the evildoers will always be here in reckless abundance. And so when you look at your life, how can you expect that you will travel the road that I've traveled and many of you have traveled and not have bumps in the road? One thing in church you hear, Lord, don't move my mountains, just give me the strength to climb. And I think the Lord has given me the strength to climb those mountains. And because I know that there is a populace that has been shut out, ignored, and they are angry. And I know that my voice has to be heard to speak for them. There's a lot of work to be done, and I can't worry about who don't agree with me, who are trying to hurt me for their own aggrandizement, because I think the Lord is still sitting high and looking low.
Well,
so as we travel this road, remember, we have a city to take care of. We have people who are expecting that our leadership will be inspirational, and they're looking for that. And when all of this is over, let the historians write that there lived a people that understood that they had a date with destiny, and they kept it. Thank you so very much.
Right. We'll be right back.